Everywhere we look these days, there's evidence of the tech boom, supposedly exciting, thrilling, wonderful for us all. Well, maybe not for all of us. One of San Francisco's legendary figures, who celebrates a birthday today, laments what it's done to his city. Jeffrey Brown explains.
At 96, Lawrence Ferlinghetti, poet, painter, and publisher, is still revered as a cultural treasure in the San Francisco Bay Area.
How are you? I brought you some flowers.
A recent opening for a retrospective exhibition of his artwork at the Marin Museum of Contemporary Art drew a large crowd.
You really, truly are a legend of the Bay Area.
Thank you.
Ferlinghetti once wrote, "All I ever wanted to do was to paint light on the walls of life." And that he's done here in poetry.
The changing light in San Francisco is a sea light, an island light, and the light of fog blanketing the hills, drifting in at night through the Golden Gate to lie on the city at dawn.
When Ferlinghetti first arrived in San Francisco from New York in 1951, he settled into a $65 a month apartment in the Italian working class neighborhood of North Beach.
It was still the last frontier when I arrived in 1951. It was a wide open city. You could come here and start anything you wanted, because in New York City it would have been impossible to start a bookstore unless you had lots of money.
Ferlinghetti opened City Light's bookshop and publishing house in 1953, the beginning of his journey to help put San Francisco on the world's countercultural map. He published the works of beat writers such as Allen Ginsberg and Jack Kerouac. For decades, on a range of causes, he served as an anti-establishment conscience for San Franciscans.
Women's liberation means men's liberation.
But these days, the establishment has changed, along with his city. Today, San Francisco is better known as a central hub of the tech boom, a city of entrepreneurs and companies like Twitter that have become international giants. And while that boom is credited with driving unemployment to an all-time low, it's also blamed for rapid gentrification, making the city unaffordable for many. And that rankles Ferlinghetti.
Dot-com millionaires and generally Silicon Valley money have moved into San Francisco with bags full of cash and no manners.
The pace of change, Ferlinghetti says, has quickened beyond control, but it's not a new issue for him. He read for us a passage from a 2001 piece titled "The Poetic City That Was."
50 years later, he awoke one fine morning looking for anywhere he could live and work. The new owners of his old flat now wanted $4,500 a month, and many of his friends were also evicted.
One example close to home, the George Krevsky Gallery in downtown San Francisco, which had shown Ferlinghetti's work for two decades, was forced out of its building to make way for a cloud computing startup called MuleSoft. Krevsky now sells most of his artwork online. Of course, Ferlinghetti's is not the only view of San Francisco these days. When a version of this story was posted online recently, he did draw support, but there were a few strong blasts as well. "What a crank," wrote one person. "The city is still as vibrant and creative as it ever was, except now young, ambitious people are in tech." Another wrote, "In 60 years, I'll be complaining about the new crop of San Franciscans. Fogies gonna fog." Still, Ferlinghetti himself continues to find his own way forward through poetry.
There's always hope in love. And love and hate are viruses. Love can make a civilization bloom, and hate can kill a civilization. This is a little poem which is full of hope. One grand boulevard with trees, one grand cafe in sun, with very black coffee in very small cups. One not necessarily very beautiful man or woman who loves you. One fine day.
I'm Jeffrey Brown for the PBS NewsHour.